Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to the class. So here we are in the second important chapter. What is the name of the chapter? Yes, it is agriculture. What do you mean by agriculture? What does this term agriculture refers to? What is that agriculture? Yes, good. It is a art and science of cultivating the soil, growing the crops, and rearing the animals is called as agriculture. Is not the agriculture is a Latin word. The agri refers to soil. Culture means cultivation. Cultivation of a soil mainly it's called as agriculture. So in India we practice agriculture in a two different methods. What are those? Yes, subsistence farming, commercial farming. Earlier totally the agriculture was dependent on our, like it was the subsistence farming earlier totally. Mainly it was primitive type of farming, but now it has become intensive and now most of agriculture activities is commercial method or commercial form of agriculture they are having. So you know, because of the civilization and modernity, we will discuss the difference between primitive subsistence agriculture and intensive subsistence agriculture. So we are subsistence farming, otherwise subsistence agriculture, anything. So in under the subsistence agriculture we have two types. What are those? Yes, primitive subsistence agriculture, then intensive subsistence agriculture. So these are the two important types in under this intensive. Here as I discussed in the last class, the primitive word, what do you mean by primitive? Yes, it's a old form of agriculture. Old form means there in the agricultural activity we make use of old methods, old tools are used, old way of cultivating the soil, old way of growing the crops are practiced in under this primitive subsistence agriculture. Here in the intensive, it's this intensive subsistence agriculture is somewhat quite having difference. It's having somewhat contrast. It has two different things in under this subsistence farming. But the main common similarity among these two is whatever the crops are grown in this are to made use, means like these crops are used to satisfy their needs, means family needs, the farmer themselves. They itself, they grow the crops in the agriculture field and they consume the crops for their satisfaction, to satisfy their needs, is not. So this is the only main thing, like a main similarity in among these two. Then apart from this we have many differences. We will discuss what are those differences we have in these two divisions of the subsistence farming. Here it's a old form of farming. It's an old form of farming. That means the old tools. The primitive tools are used in this farming or agriculture activity or farming activities like hoe and so this is the two important tools. You know the salake, it's a hoe, and now it's the salake, it will be like this in you know what this is not. You have some of these things, the tool. So here earlier the people they were using these things or this tool to dig the land, to separate, to make contours. To make a contours they were using this tool called as hoe. And another one to chop the trees, to chop the like waste plants, weeds, to chop the weeds, they were using this kind of Here the holding is here, and to chop, it's like a sword. It looks like a sword, but it's not a sword actually. And it will be somewhat longer, the long tools, and they were using this to chop the trees. Even now, wherever the places they were practicing this primitive subsistence activity or agriculture, they are using these tools. Why they will use these tools? Why can't they use machines like tractors? We have many tools we are having along with that, is not? Why they don't use here in under the primitive subsistence agriculture? They don't use because they are poor, very poor. They don't have money to offer all those things. Access to the resources, they don't have money. And they are poor people. So that reason, in their agriculture field, the only family members they work. They don't have money to hire workers, to hire laborers. They don't have money to pay back them. So that's the reason their family members they work as laborers in their agriculture field. So here, the plot of land is very small. The size of land or small size land, small plot of land or small size land. Used to grow crops, and here they don't use a chemical fertilizers, chemical pesticides. They don't use in this primitive. Why? As I told, because they are poor, is it not? The old tools are used, and the small plot of land, and they are mainly dependent on the monsoon. They are dependent on monsoon. What happens in the monsoon during a monsoon? So what is another name for monsoon? Rainy season. In the last year we discussed, you know, rainy season. So they depend on the monsoon to get a rain. So they are not having the money to get a availability of water into their agriculture field. It's small plot of land. So they don't waste time like a money by getting the water from other sources, is it not? So they wait for the monsoon. And since they don't add any chemical fertilizer pesticide in that, they wait to get the fertility in the soil itself. So when monsoon happens, prevails in that particular places, along with the water, the soil gets its fertility when the time passes. When the time passes, along with like ashes, when they burn the things, so along with the ashes, they will get a, means like a soil, it will get its own humus, fertility. So they will wait for the natural way of fertilizing the soil. They depended on monsoon, natural fertility. Natural fertility of soil. Because they don't have fertilizer, pesticides, because they don't have money. And their family members work as laborers. They act as laborers. They work as laborers. In their agriculture field, they work. They only work in the agriculture field. They don't hire any money there because they don't have money. Then, because with all these activities, what might be the result? They are having a small plot of land. They are not adding fertility, fertilizer, chemical fertilizer, and any pesticide into this agriculture field. They are not using HPV seeds. They are not providing much water into them. Then what might be the result? Very low yield. The result will be less, is not? So they don't use, means, yeah, they don't use HYV seeds. Means high yield varieties of seeds are not used here. Then the low productivity, because of all those things they will be having a low productivity. What are the products like a yield they will get in this primitive subsistence agriculture? They will make use to satisfy their needs, and it will be okay for them to lead their life, and it is satisfactory for them. So it's a primitive subsistence agriculture. Then we'll compare this all the factors with this type of subsistence farming. Here, in this farming, the old tools are used, but here the new and modern machines. Is it visible if I write there? Not for you in this camera. Is it visible? Okay. So this new and modern machineries are used in this agriculture. It's a modern type of agriculture. Modern. The same plot of land is somewhat dullet. Comparing with this, it is somewhat bigger land is used. The size of land is more, like the crops grown in wider area. In a large area, produce. We say it's large area. Now it's a large plot of agriculture. Not much large, but somewhat larger compared with this primitive agriculture. Then they depend on monsoon. So here they are not depending on the monsoon. Then what they will do? Like chemical fertilizer and pesticides and irrigation facilities are adopted. Mainly the irrigation facilities. Irrigation facility, what we get from the irrigation facility? The availability of water. Irrigation is nothing but we have our different types of irrigation. Sprinkle irrigation, drip irrigation. It's all the irrigation system. Irrigation facilities are adopted here. Facilities. Irrigation facilities and chemical fertilizers. Are used. Irrigation facility mainly. Chemical fertilizers are used here. It's a large, it's grown, the crops are grown in the larger area. Then modern machines are used. Then the family members, they work as a labor. It's a labor intensive farming. Labor intensive farming. Labor intensive farming is nothing but, so this farming is based on the labors, means they require more labors. Here they use machines as well as they require more labors, since it's a very large area and they use chemical fertilizers and all those things. Then here they don't use, here in the primitive subsistence, they don't use HYV seeds. Means high yield varieties. Here, high yield varieties of seeds are used. Then, so because of all this activity, finally we get a low productivity. But here it's older because the modern things are used. So the high productivity, you will be getting high yield or high productivity. So because of all these things, high productivity you will be getting in this intensive subsistence farming. In India mainly, the most of the land or most of the agriculture land, it's they are practicing the intensive subsistence farming. Most of the agriculture land is under this intensive subsistence farming. And some other areas we have primitive subsistence farming. So this primitive subsistence farming, it is having a two types, the two methods or two types are there in this. Like it's also called as shifting agriculture. Otherwise, slash and burn agriculture. It's a one type. We have two types in this. It's one shifting agriculture. Slash and burn agriculture and nomadic herding. Nomadic herding, like rearing animals. moving from one place to another places in search of food along with the animals. It's called as nomadic herding. We discuss about that. So here shifting, it's also called shifting agriculture, primitive, because old. In the ancient period, we started a slash and burn agriculture first. It's also called as shifting agriculture. So we have a different name for this in the different areas of India. We'll discuss that. Is that all? We have only one name for this, intensive subsistence agriculture. There is one another name. Is it over? Make it fast. Is that good? So we call this with a different name. Regionally, we have a different name for this primitive subsistence farming. Like a different names, regional different names. We call it as Jhumming. In eastern part of India. In the eastern part, what we have the seven sisters, we say they are in the eastern part, we call it as Jhumming. Manipur, Nagaland, Mizoram, Assam. In these four states, we call or they call it as Jhumming for this primitive subsistence agriculture. Then we call it as Deepa in Madhya Pradesh. Pamlu in Chhattisgarh. These are the different names. In Madhya Pradesh, they say means they indicate this is with a name called as Deepa. In Chhattisgarh, it's called as Pamlu. In India, so this subsistence farming, like a primitive subsistence farming, is not only there in India, it's not only practiced in India. It's practiced in all over the world, means not everywhere, in those particular places, like in South America, in Africa mainly, and North America, part of North America and Australia, they are practicing this. As like in India, you don't practice in every nook and corner of India, only in a particular places, like in the forest areas. They practice same like that, in the particular other places, they practice this kind of activities. For example, in the Brazil, in the South America, they call it as a milpa, regional name. It's a milpa in Brazil. Means they have a name for this primitive subsistence farming in a Brazil, but it's a milpa. Is it over? So now another one segment, another one division, another one type of agriculture, method of farming is commercial. Commercial farming. Commercial agriculture, otherwise farming. So this commercial farming, it has the quite in contrast with the primitive or otherwise intensive subsistence agriculture. It is totally different than the subsistence agriculture. The main intention of a subsistence agriculture is to get a use from their agricultural activity for their family members. Means directly they consume the products. Their main idea is not. So their practices in the small plot of a land. in primitive substance they use as old tools, but here the main intention of these farming is to sell that product in the market to get a income. The commercial, the word itself says it's a commercial, like a like exchanging the goods and the money. So it's a commercial activity, isn't it? So that activity which is related with the money, so it's a commercial. So these crops, this farming, which is mainly having intention of selling the product in the market to get a income. The main intention of this type of a farming is to sell in the market. To get income or money. It's the main intention. The intention is to sell in the market. Whatever the product we get there in the agriculture activity, completely they sell in the market. They don't make it to satisfy their needs. It's about a commercial activity. Then the large, very large area, the large land used to grow the crops. Here the large, very large land is used. Not like intensive farming, here around more than 100 acres, more than 200, 500 acres are used to grow the crops. In this commercial farming, they use modern techniques, modern technologies are used with HYB seeds and chemical fertilizers. Is it a labor intensive farming? It's a very large area, isn't it? It's very large area, like more than 500 acres, more than 100 or 200 acres. These type of activities mostly practiced in foreign countries. In India we practice this, but we don't use much land to grow these commercial farmings. We don't use a larger area than the other foreign countries. There in the North America, South America, in the Europe, and even in the Asia, there are many countries. They make use of this, means they are practicing the commercial farming activities. There they use around 500 or 200 acres of land, is belong to one person. It's such a very vast land, isn't it? Then there is a need of more labors, workers, it's required more workers. Here for 1 acre we use 5 to 6 labors to sow the seeds, 1 or 2, it is not, to harvest, to weeding the crops. There are 5 to 6 people, we take help of them. Then it is 500 acres, they require more than 200-300 people. Is that labor intensive farming? No. It's a machine intensive farming, because since it's very large area, you might be saw in the pictures or the videos, in a foreign countries, they put a fertilizer, pesticides by using helicopters. So because it's very vast area, then within an hour or within a day, they can complete activity by using the machines, isn't it? So it's a machine intensive farming. Machine intensive farming. Then more productivity. So you know we are using a very large area. There we use a very large land to grow the crops. And the modern tech technologies like machines and as well seeds and chemical fertilizer used. It's a machine intensive. So that reason in the final we'll be having more productivity. Both the food and fodder crops are grown here. Both food and fodder crops grow. Food crops, you know about that, so to sell in the market, mainly the commercial farming activities. And the fodder crops, the food for the animals, to feed the animals, it's a fodder crops, mayo. So here, along with the food crops, the fodder crops, mayo also grown here, along with the food crops. Then, you know, in the foreign countries, in South America, North America, they will be having the farmhouse. Now also they are having a farmhouse in their agriculture field because it's a very large area. Every farmers, they are using a laptop here, laptop. So they use a laptop, they will be get connected with the satellite. Why? The satellite map, you know about that map. They make use of the map to sow the seed, to get to know their the length and width of the size of their agriculture field. They will make use of a map because it is a very vast area. They cannot walk, they cannot run, is it not? That's the reason they make use of the Google map there in the foreign, in this commercial farming activities. So this commercial farming activities, it has many different methods, different types of things in this, like types. We have types like this: plantation, then mixed farming. These are the two types of this commercial farming. Plantation, you know, the single crop grown in a large area. The single crop grown in a large area is a plantation. Then the mixed farming. Both the food crops and fodder crops are grown in together, and as well as it may be two food crops along with the sugar, along with the wheat, growing the maize in the same field, same large acres there. So it's like a mixed farming. These two are the examples for this commercial farming. We practice plantation. This we practice plantation in India, so even in India, like a banana and the sugar cane. It's also the example for this plantation. Coffee, tea, mainly coffee, tea, banana, sugarcane, it's example of this plantation. So in India also we are practicing this commercial farming, but not a wide range comparing with other countries. So then mixed farming, you know, even now here also in India also we are practicing this mixed farming. Farming like suppose we are growing sugarcane there, suppose we are growing a maize, in between that we are growing some ullagatti, shenga, is it not? It's a mixed farming. In the same single agriculture year or agriculture season, we are going with double crops, it's mixed farming. And if you are growing fodder crops with the food crops, it's also called as mixed farming. So this mixed farming and plantation is widely practiced in the commercial, in other countries. It's mainly for the commercial farming. In India, it's been practiced, but not in that wide ranges. So is that clear? These are the two types of a farming or methods, two methods of a growing of crops, and the two methods are having two different intentions. In a subsistence farming, we have the intention is to satisfy ourselves, like the family members and farmer needs. To satisfy the needs, they grow in their agriculture field. But here, the totally is different. Whatever the crops they grow, it's to sell in the market. It's a cash crops. In the commercial farming, they grow the cash crops. Is that clear? Shall I wrap it? So it's about the methods, types of farming. Then in India, we have our seasons, particular seasons, not climatic season. I'm discussing about, or I'm talking about this cropping season, agriculture seasons. We have three agriculture seasons in India. Means, what is agriculture season? The What is that agriculture season? It's nothing but growing different crops in a particular seasons. Growing otherwise say growing the same crop in a particular season. In particular season, growing a particular crops in that is what is this cropping pattern. So this cropping pattern or cropping season, the both same cropping pattern and cropping season as a three. One is called as Kharif crop, means the crop which grown in the particular season. It is a Kharif crop. Another one Rabi crop. Another one Zaid crop. So it's about cropping. Cropping season or pattern. Agriculture season, you can say. It's a cropping pattern, isn't it? Here we have a three patterns, like a three seasons. Growing crops in a particular season, like crops grown in particular season. Cropping season or cropping pattern. So in India we have three cropping patterns. One is called as Kharif crop, another one the Rabi, then Zaid crop. These are the three types of crops what we have in India. These three types of crops are grown in a different seasons. These three means, you know, the every crops which we grow in India, it's not required equal temperature as like other crops is required. It's not required equal rainfall as like other crops is required. Every crops required a different temperature and different rainfall to grow, isn't it? Because every crop cannot have the same protein and every crop cannot grow in the same under the same climatic conditions. So according to the climatic conditions, we have four climatic conditions, means seasons, isn't it? What are those? Monsoon, southwest monsoon, then retrograde monsoon, summer, then winter. These are the four climatic conditions. So this, in among these four climatic conditions, we have divided into three cropping patterns. Means according to these climatic reasons or climatic conditions, the crops are grown. Suppose like what we say, the rice, it's required high rainfall. It required more water to grow, isn't it? So in among these three climatic conditions, in which climatic conditions we can grow the crop? Yes, it is in a monsoon season, isn't it? Then suppose for a millet, like a ragi. Ragi is required very dry, means it don't require much water. With a less water, less amount of water and the moderate temperature, it can grow in any soil with some irrigation method or some particular methods, it can be grown. So we can grow that in during the winter season. At the same season, like in the Kharif and winter, both we can grow that. So here, these are the crops. It's like Kharif crops. It has a particular group of crops. It has some crops in this group. In the Rabi crop, it has some crops in this group. Zaid crop also has some crops in that group. So this every types of every crops can grow in the particular season. So that season has given it the name Kharif, Rabi, Zaid. Here, the Kharif crops which grown in a rainy season. Kharif crops, the crops which are grown from the June to October, rainy season, is not June to October, it's called as Kharif crop. From October to the May, April, May, it's called as Rabi crop. So here, this Rabi crop, it's mainly lies in the winter season and somewhat of the summer. So Zaid crop, it comes in between these two. So So we can grow this crop, Zaid crops, along with the Kharif crops and also along with the Rabi crops. It's called as Rabi Zaid, Kharif Zaid. ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಏನು ಗ್ರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಈ ಒಂದು ಆರು ತಿಂಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸಪೋಸ್ ನಾಲ್ಕು ತಿಂಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಗ್ರೋ ದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ರಾಬಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 6 ಮಂತ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 5 ಮಂತ್ ಸೊ ಜಾಯಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ 2 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ 2 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಝೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಾಯಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಾಬಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಜಾಯಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೀಸನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ The summer season. We'll get a summer here, is not. In between these two things, we grow the Zaid crop. So we'll discuss what are those crops. And these crops that is required, the whatever the crops comes under the Kharif crops, they requires high temperature, high rainfall. So that can be grown in this season. These crops that requires low temperature, moderate rainfall. So that can be grown in this year. Means that. If we grow the crops, it's like the rabi crop, the wheat, if you grow the wheat in this season, you will get a good yield. Suppose, you can grow in the kharif season, like a zoom. So if you grow the crop, wheat crop in the zoom, will you get a good crop, will you get a good yield there? No? Because with the more rainfall, the maize, otherwise the wheat, the maize, suppose, with a high rainfall, the maize cannot grow well. It will die. You don't get a good yield there. Suppose if you grow the rice here, you don't get a good yield because rice requires high temperature, high rainfall, but you don't get high rainfall in these months. But you don't get a high temperature, same high temperature rainfall not again. So that reason it cannot grow well. So the particular crops are grown in the particular seasons. And that season has given with a name called as Kharif, Rabi, then Zaid. So it's called as the cropping pattern. It's about we discuss the introductions. Tomorrow I will explain about this Kharif, Rabi, and Zaid. We'll discuss detail about these things. I hope you understood about this concept what we discussed today. The classic like types of farming, methods of farming, maybe the classification of farming, and the cropping patterns we discuss. And we'll continue the same things the next coming.